in material science and engineering, we are not only look at different kind of materials and how the material are used. We have to look more than that. As material scientists and engineers, you must have a particular way of looking materials. Try to understand the relationship among structure, properties, and processing. It involves studies and control the composition and structure of material across to control materials properties through synthesis and processing. This is a branch of knowledge in material science and engineering. I give an actual example of actual research. Different photoelectrochemical could be achieved by varying process condition. By varying argon gas flow rate from 5 cm cubic per minute to 25 cm cubic per minute, 14 film deposited by thermal vacuum evaporation in the presence of argon gas, better photorespond under light or sun can be achieved. The material then can be used as solar cells film. Film deposited under lower gas flow rate and higher argon flow rate show different compositions and structure. Under lower gas flow rate, the film consists a mixture of copper zinc tin selenide and zinc selenide structure. While film deposited at higher argon gas flow rate, 25 cm cubic per minute, consists copper zinc dope tin selenide structure, which not consists copper zinc tin selenide and zinc selenide. The term composition here means the chemical make of a materials. The structure means the arrangements of atoms. So, in the previous example, synthesis of copper zinc dope tin selenide was made from starting material copper zinc tin selenide under argon gas atmosphere. And the processing condition shaped the films into useful component to cause changes in the properties of different materials. In this example, a material researcher understands how to control the properties of materials by using processing to change the structure. In material science, the importance is on the underlying relationship between synthesis and processing, structure and properties. However, in engineering, the focus is on how to transform materials into useful devices. In this example, the deposited semiconductor films can be useful device for photoelectrochemical solar cell. Let's consider metal selenide film using the material science engineering relationship among structure, properties, processing, and performance. In pure silicon semiconductor, the concentration of electrons and holes is equals. In order to increase the conductivity, a process called doping is done on the pure semiconductor by adding foreign atoms. However, electronic property of semiconductor metal chalcogenides depends on the carrier concentrations that is determined by acceptor and donor concentration. The advantage of using thin film is it requires small amount of materials and the ease of processing with only one parameter to control in order to enhance conversion efficiency. The questions material scientists and engineers must answer with application of semiconductor metal chalcogenide films are: what are the relationship between the structure of metal chalcogenide and their photoelectrochemical property? How PEC device can make using this metal dope thin selenide? Will this device be compatible with existing silicon semiconductor technology? And how robust are these devices? How will the performance and cost of this device compare with traditional devices? These are a few factors that engineers and scientists must consider during the development, design, manufacturing of semiconductor metal chalcogenide film for photoelectrochemical cell devices.